Hi everyone. This tutorial gives an overview of the tools which are available for cryo-EM data in Phenix. The video shows a walkthrough and gives a brief overview of the tools. Details of each program will be discussed in separate tutorials. Here's an overview of the workflow. Please note that all the programs can be run via the graphical user interface or the command line. In the beginning, there can be two scenarios. The first scenario is to start with a map file only. The second scenario is to have a map and a docked model. The first program to use is mTriage, which tries to assess the quality of the map and establish knowledge of certain pathologies that might be present. The next step is to obtain a sharpened map. This task can be performed with AutoSharpen. The program automatically identifies the adjustment to create an optimized map. If there is no initial model available, it has to be created before advancing to the next steps. Automatic model building can be performed with the tool Map to Model. The model and the optimized map are then inspected and changed in graphics program, and the modified model is subsequently refined with Wheel Space Refine. The refined model is validated and checked for errors, and then again inspected in a graphics program. This cycle of refinement, validation, and model building is repeated to create the best possible model. After a final step of validation, the model and data are deposited. The programs can be accessed via the Phenix GUI, but the graphical user interfaces for Map to Model and AutoSharpen are currently in the alpha development stage and not visible in the normal user mode of the program. To activate the alpha mode, go to the Phenix main window and choose Preferences. Under the section General, scroll down and make sure the box next to Enable Alpha Test Programs and Features is activated. You might have to restart the Phenix GUI to activate the changes. Now let's have a look at the individual programs. To start mTriage, go to Data Analysis and click on the Program button, which opens a new window. Minimal input for mTriage is a map in CCP4 format. Additionally, the program can use a model and two half maps. Please note that here and for all other programs, the input model should be already docked to the map. The Result tab shows map statistics, a histogram of map values, and an estimate of the resolution. If a model was provided, there are additional resolution estimates, and the Map Model FSC tab shows a plot of the Fourier shell correlation. It is recommended to compare the resolution estimate from mTriage to the one obtained from data processing and choose the resolution which is the most representative of the map. The next step is to run AutoSharpen. Go to Maps and scroll all the way down to find the Program button. Minimal input is a map file. In addition, a model file can be used. The Results tab shows a summary of the sharpening results. The program outputs the sharpened map in CCP4 format and a MTZ file with map coefficients. If no model is available, it can be built automatically into the map. To open Map to Model, go to the category Model Building in the main window. Recommended inputs are the sharpened map file, the high resolution limit, a sequence file, and, if applicable, the symmetry used in reconstruction. Please note that typical runtimes can be very long. If you have a multiprocessor machine, you can specify the number of processors in the input settings, which will speed up the runtime. The next step is to perform refinement. The program Real Space Refine can be found under Refinement, then choose Real Space Refine. Minimal inputs are a model file, a map file, and the resolution. Refinement options can be changed in the Settings tab. Please note that a more detailed tutorial for Real Space Refine is available on this channel. Once the job is complete, additional tabs will appear reporting the output files, final statistics, and the results from the Molprobity Validation Analysis. It is important to go through all the validation criteria and to make sure to address all reported problems. The Molprobity Analysis can be performed separately from refinement as well. To do this, go to the Phenix main window and choose Validation, then click on Comprehensive Validation. By default, the program is set to be used with X-ray diffraction data, so make sure to change the controls to cryo-EM. Required input files are model file, a map file, and the resolution. When validation is finished, three new tabs appear. The mole probity tab includes a summary and detailed validation results. The real space correlation tab shows correlation coefficients. The atomic properties tab shows sanity checks such as for occupancy and B factors. I hope this tutorial was helpful. If you have any questions, contact us at help@phoenix-online.org or tutorials@phoenix-online.org.